Yes. Hi all, welcome to Shivagana aptitude classes. In this video I am going to explain the solutions of the reasoning ability questions which are asked in the Amazon 2021 recruitment. So very recent question paper that I am explaining. The mostly the questions that I am going to cover are reasoning ability questions. Right, we'll see. So definitely this video will be helpful for your preparation plan in the upcoming drives. I'm sure the best questions that are asked most frequently questions in most of the MNCs in the written test, such kind of questions are asked in the Amazon also. So definitely the questions that I'm going to cover in this video, there is a lot of chance to get the similar kind of questions in the upcoming drives also. Right, make use of this video lecture as best as possible, my dear viewers. Thank you one and all. Let us start. The first question: Aaron was riding on his bike. He rode 50 yards south. So definitely by reading the first two statements, it is the question from directions. Definitely there is a question from direction sense in every written test in the part of reasoning ability. So this is the basic diagram. So from this basic diagram, what? Riding bike 50 yards south. Let us say this is 50 yards south. I'm just changing the color for better presentation. Let us say from this point 50 yards south is this one. Now Arun is here facing towards south. Now turn left and ride 70 yards. Very basic question. Turn left 70 yards. Now he is facing east. Okay, he took another left turn. The east facing person left turn is north, and how much? 50 yards. Okay, this is left turn 50 yards. Now he is facing north. So then he take the right turn. Right turn in the sense north facing person, right turn is east. How much? 60. Let us say this is 60. This is the end point. This is the end point. In which direction is he from the starting point? How far? You have to write the distance. How far and also in which direction? Both questions. How far and in which direction? From the starting, from this starting, how far? 70 plus 60, 130. The only option with 130 is this one. So answer 130 east. 130 adds east. Right, very very important basic question from the topic of direction sense. I explained beautifully direction sense in four videos. For that you can contact this one, and I also written the same content in the books also that was present. Next question: considering the directions of the course, some course are given. So of course, yeah, this question is also direction sense question, but asked in a different way. A at the rate B means A is 10 yards to the left of B. Okay, so what is the position of Z with respect to W? If the direction of Z is given like this, this is the direction of Z. Yeah, first of all, we'll see. Z at the rate of X, percentage Y, dollar symbol W. So first I just want to resolve this one. Z at the rate of X means, at the rate symbol is what? Left. So Z is 10 yards to the left of B, to the left of X. This is the first statement. Next, X percentage Y. Percentage means what? This is percentage. So next statement is X is 20 yards. X is 20 yards to the left of, to the left of Y. Next I am going to resolve this one. Y dollar symbol W. Dollar is this one, right? So what is the statement? why is 5 yards to the right? Y is 5 yards to the right of W. So these are the three statements. Now putting these three statements in the diagram. This is north, this is south, this is east, this is west. Basic diagram. First one is Z is 10 yards to the left of X. To the 10 yards to the left. For example, if X is here, if X is here, 10 yards to the left of X, who is there? Z. I'm changing the color for better presentation. So this is 10 yards. Z is 10 yards to the left of X. Second statement, X is 20 yards to the left of Y. Let us say Y is here. Let us say Y is here. This is total of how many? 20 yards. This total is 20 yards. So to the left of Y, 20 yards, X is there. Now Y is 5 yards to the right of W. Right of W, 5 yards. So definitely, right of W, definitely. So if W is here, this will be 5 yards. This will be 5 yards. To the right of W, 5 yards, Y. Now the question is what? What is the position of Z with respect to W? So this is the position of Z. With respect to W, this is how much distance? This is 10 plus and this is 15. 20 minus 5, 15. 25. So Z is 25 yards to the left of W. That's the answer for this question. Right? It has been given codes. From those codes, you need to frame these statements. From these statements, I just drawn the diagram, right? So the best idea is to draw the diagram according to the statements. You will get everything. You will get whatever the direction, the distances. These are all the basic questions in the direction sense topic. Very basic question that they are asked in the top-notch company, Amazon. Next question. What is this question? We'll see. The given signs denotes some signs are given. Percentage denotes greater than. Okay. Which of the two conclusions? Fantastic question. Good quality question. Right. So this is the question based on equalities. Inequalities is the topic. The books that I was written in that there is a topic called inequalities. Generally, this inequality topics is going to be asked in the bank examinations. Now this was the question, this topic has been asked in the Amazon Drive. So definitely there is a chance to get the inequality topics in the next upcoming drives also. So right, yeah, we'll see. So what are the statements? First we'll see the statement one is what? A percentage D. Statements are A percentage. Percentage is what? Percentage is nothing but what? Greater than. So which means A greater than B, this was given. Next is what? C is equal to A. Equality means what? Not less than. Which means greater than or equal to. C greater than or equal to A. So this is. Okay. Next one is what? D star B. D star B. Star in the sense what? Not greater than. Not which means less than or equal to. So D less than or equal to B. So these are the things that was given between A, B, C, D, some of the relations. Okay. Now coming to the conclusion one. What is the first conclusion? A ash B. Ash meaning is what? Less than. Which means A less than B. There is no A less than A ash D, not B. This is D. State conclusion is A ash D. Ash in this is less than. A less than D. There is no direct relation between A and D. So I'm going to establish that relation between A and D like this. So A greater than B. And we can write B. B greater than or equal to D. This one and this one I clubbed. So from this, what the relation? Definitely A greater than D, that will occur. But he is given A less than D. We got A greater than B, but this conclusion is A less than D. So conclusion one, false. This is absolutely false. Now let us see conclusion two. What is conclusion two? Conclusion two is C star E. Star in the sense, what the meaning of star? Not greater than. So C is less than or equal to B. C is less than or equal to B. Not B, E. This is E, right? C less than or equal to E. But here C greater than or equal to E is the statement. But the conclusion is C less than or equal to E. So which is false? Conclusion 2 also false. So neither conclusion 1 nor conclusion 2 is true. Answer for this question is option D. Good quality question asked from the topic of inequalities. For the inequality topics, you can check my books that I was written. In that I explained at a length of 10 to 12 pages. Inequality covering of around 45 questions with beautiful solutions. Next one. The given question is followed by the two statements. Decide the statements. So this is the topic called data sufficiency. Data sufficiency topic. There is a huge scope, a lot of scope to ask in the drive of TCS, Wipro and Mindtree and Infosys. There is a huge scope and Tech Mahindra also. Tech Mahindra last year, every slot there is a question from data sufficiency. So these are all the companies are definitely give the question from data sufficiency. So the candidates who are preparing for these companies, data sufficiency is one of the important topic. So not only for these companies and for all the companies, data sufficiency is also important, even for banking also. The first statement is C is to the right of D. So first of all, the question is A, B, C, D are sitting in a row. Who is sitting in the extreme right? Extreme right. Okay. Extreme right, who is? For that, the statement 1 is what? Statement 1 is C is to the right of D. If we use statement 1 alone, what is the result? C is right of D. 1, 2, 3, 4. C is right of D. Meaning is, if D is here, C is here. If D is here, C is here. If D is here, C is here. We don't know the place. Now it was not given that exact right or left. Who is sitting in the extreme right? So statement 1 is alone not sufficient. Statement 1 alone not sufficient to answer this question. Statement 1 alone not sufficient to answer this question. Let us check this statement 2. Statement 2. B is to the left of A. B is to the left of A. It is not extreme left or immediate left. B is left of A. 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 Anything is possible. From this arrangements, we cannot decide who is extreme left. And also there is no facing information whether these persons are facing right or facing north, facing south. Such kind of information is also not given. So second statement is not sufficient alone to answer. Second statement also not sufficient to answer. So for example, if we club these two, if we use both statements, is it possible? No, not possible. If we club both statement 1 and 2 also, we cannot answer this question. That's it. So both statements even put together are not sufficient to answer the problem question. This is the answer for the question. The data is insufficient. Viewers, the basic thing about this topic is we have to answer the question based on the given statements. Whether we can able to answer the question with the first statement alone or not. whether the given question can be answerable with the second statement alone or not, or sometimes both statements are necessary. That judgment we have to decide. So in this question, both statements are not sufficient to answer. Even both statements are put together, not sufficient to answer this question. That's why the answer is this one. This is about data sufficiency, one of the premier important topic for all the placements. Definite question in upcoming drives, my dear viewers. Next, another data sufficiency question. I have four friends. What is my age? I have four friends. What is my age? Average, I have four friends. What is my age? What is the first statement? This is the first statement. Average of our ages is 85 years. Let us say A, B, C, D, four persons. It is mine. Average is 85. So each person age we can take as 85. A age 85, B age 85, C age 85, D age 85 we can take, are also different, but sum is 85 into 4. Okay. Statement 1 is alone not sufficient to answer my age. Statement 1 alone is not sufficient to answer. Let us discuss about statement 2 alone. All of us are of the same age. Statement 2 is not alone to answer what is my age. Just look at statement 2 alone. All of us are of the same age. Okay. This statement is not sufficient to answer this question alone. Right. If we put these statements together, is it possible to answer? Yes, definite possible. So average is 85. All of them having equal or same age. So my age is 85. We can decide. So if we put both statements together, we can answer. Therefore, both statements put together are sufficient to answer this question. Option C is the right answer. Both statements are necessary to answer this question. Good quality question. Two questions from data sufficiency. I am sure in upcoming drives also there is a definite question from data sufficiency. Syllogisms, coding, decoding, blood relation, analogy, classification. These are the most important topics in the current placements in the view of what? Logical reasoning. As a part of logical reasoning, these are most important topics. Data sufficiency, syllogisms, which means logical deductions, syllogisms, coding, decoding, blood relation, analogy and classification. These are the important topics, and order and ranking also, right? First of all, you should be good at these topics. Then see the rest of the topics. Yeah, next question. Yeah, this is also what data sufficiency. Among five friends A, B, C, D, E, who is taller? We have to decide who is taller. What is the first statement? B is taller than A. Okay, B is taller than A. Okay, between B and A, there might be C, D, or there may not be C, D, E. Okay. But shorter than D and E. I'm talking about first statement alone. B is taller than A, but belongs to B. B is shorter than D and E. D and E. So D and E, we don't know between D and E relation. Who is shorter, who is longer between D and E, we don't know. But definitely D and E are on top of B and A. But what we need, who is tallest? So from the statement 1 information, we cannot answer this question. Who is tallest? We cannot answer the question from the statement 1 alone. Now let us discuss statement 2 alone. C is shorter than B. with this statement we cannot answer the question who is tallest. Who is tallest? We cannot answer. We cannot answer who is tallest from the statement. For example, if we put both statements together, B is taller than A. B is taller than A, but shorter than D and E. But shorter than D and E. And C is shorter than B. C is shorter than B. Right. C can be here or C can be here. But here the question is who is tallest. We cannot decide who is tallest if even if we put both statements together. Even if we put both statements together, we cannot answer the question of who is tallest. So either the statements, either of the statements is sufficient to answer. No, both statements even put together are insufficient. Option D. Both statements even put together are not sufficient to answer. Good quality question, my dear viewers. Fantastic question. Three questions from data sufficiency. Let us see. Okay, right. This is a number analogy. This kind of question is nothing but number analogy. 865:532. Okay. :976. Right. Based on this pattern, what is? See, my dear viewers, it is easy to answer the question. It is easy to listen the solution. But it is really difficult to get the idea about reasoning topics in the examination. It is really difficult. It is really smartness. Much smartness is necessary to answer the logical reasoning questions. That is the reason why I always telling to each and every viewer, do minimum of 10 questions every day on reasoning so that you can sharpen your brain. Let us see this one. 865, 532, 976. Right. 862. What? 865 odd, 532 even, 976. There is no odd and even. Yeah. Let us check the differences. 86 difference is minus 2. 65 difference is minus 1. Minus 2, minus 1. Here also minus 2, minus 1. Here also minus 2, minus 1. So the pattern is minus 2, minus 1. That is satisfied with option D. 643. The pattern is minus 2, minus 1. Number analogy. For banking and government examination also, this is important topic. Next one, 985, another number analogy question. 985 874 764 763. This number analogy questions, I put a lot of questions and solutions in the books that I was written. 985 98, difference is minus 1. 53, difference is minus 3. 87 minus 1, 74 minus 3. So minus 1 minus 3 pattern. 76 minus 1, 63 minus 3. So the pattern is minus 1 minus 3. 652 option D. Minus 1 minus 3. Perfectly syncs. Cool. Easy to crack. The original Amazon questions that you are seeing. So look at how easy questions they are asking. For a lakhs of salary job. So if you focus a little bit, you can crack the Amazon company. Another analogy question. This is word based analogy. AGD:EKH:IOL:? Refer to the given terms. A pattern defines the relation between the first two terms. There is a pattern between the first two terms. Determine the relation and identity the missing term of the second pair such that both pairs are analogous. Both pairs are analogous. The topic is analogy. So A, G, D. A, जी डी ए नेक्स्ट बी सी डी नेक्स्ट वन नीज ई विच मीन्स प्लस थ्री ई जी एच ई जे के इज गिवेन दिस इज ऑल्सो प्लस थ्री डी ई एफ जी एच इज गिवेन सो परफेक्टली प्लस थ्री पैटर्न सिट्स बेस्ड ऑन दिस प्लस थ्री पैटर्न ई जे के एल नेक्स्ट विल बी एम एम नेक्स्ट ओ पी क्यू आर नेक्स्ट विल बी एस प्लस थ्री पैटर्न नेक्स्ट एल एम एन ओ पी सो एम एस पी इज द आंसर राइट एम एस पी इज द आंसर गुड क्वेश्चन एम एस पी इज द आंसर द नेक्स्ट वन सो नंबर सीरीज 3, 15, 35, 63 वॉट इज द क्वेश्चन मार्क If you have some numbers in your mind, you can definitely answer. 63 is nothing but 8 square minus 1. 64 minus 1. This is 6 square minus 1. This is 4 square minus 1. 16 square minus 1. This is 2 square minus 1. So next will be 2, 4, 6, 8. Next will be 10 square minus 1. 100 minus 1, 99. Cool answer. Easy answer. Missing number 2, 8, 5, 6, 8? 11. I already told in the number series most of the time if the number of numbers in the given series are more then there is a chance of clubbing two series 2, 5 plus 3, 5, 8 plus 3, 8, 11 plus 3 plus 3 pattern so 8 6 minus 2 so 6 minus 2 will be 4 it was there in the options that's it it is the clubbing of two different series right I explained number of questions in number series in my video lecture you can contact to this or you can see my books also there also I explained around 200 questions on number series 200 different questions on number series next one right what is this for the given options let us see this question b b c m n identify the option that is dissimilar out of these four one thing is dissimilar okay B B B next C B C next M N okay sequence is okay D D D next E okay next O P consecutive next okay if you see M M M next N W X these three are following the same pattern or nothing but similar But G G based on this pattern after G it should be H but is given N so this is dissimilar option D dissimilar right this is nothing but classification topic so next this is also classification so first option I am checking A B B next C like this a b c d second option m n o p okay cool option c t option c t u okay v W. This is also perfect. Option D will check. P. Q. M. N. P. Q. Okay. R. Yes, this is MPNO, but is given MNPO. That's why this is dissimilar. This is what we need, MPNO, but is given MNPO. That is dissimilar. Rest are all following the similar pattern. Dissimilar is option B, MNPO, but it should be MPNO. Right. A group of 5 employees need to be selected for advanced training of the organization. We have to select 5 employees. That's it. Okay. These employees have to be selected out of the 5 managers. There are 5 managers, M1, M2, M3, M4, M5, and 3 interns, I1, I2, I3. According to the given criteria. What is the criteria? There should be at least, the team should consist of at least 3 managers. So the condition is at least 3 managers, at least 3 managers, and at least 1 intern, at least 1 intern. Based on this, what are the possibilities? Based on this, what are the possibilities? At least 3 managers, at least 3 managers, and at least 1 intern, which means the first possibility is 3 managers, 1 intern, and the second possibility is 2 interns, 4 managers and 1 intern. Right, this is okay. These are the 2 possibilities. If M1 is selected, M3 should not. If M1 is selected, then M3 we cannot select. Okay. Next, if M4 is selected, okay. If M4 is selected, I2 should not be selected. I2 should not be selected. Keep it in mind. Okay. If we see this one, 3 managers. Three managers. If I select M1, M2, M3. M3 is in my list. Or if M3 is not in the list, M1, M2, M2, M4. So if M1 is selected, we cannot select M3, right? Then the possibility is M1, M2, M4, let us see one more time. Given that, so 3 managers and 2 interns, 4 managers and 1 intern, these are the 2 possibilities. Given that, what? The team should consisting of at least 3 managers, at least. If M1 is selected, then M3 should be. Right. The question is, the first question, if 4 managers are selected in the term, this is out. 4 managers are selected in the team, then this is out. Then which of the following cannot be selected? Which interim cannot be selected? 4 managers. So the possibilities are M1, M2, M4, M5. These are the 4 managers. I am taking this condition. If M3 is not selected, M1 is selected, then M3 should not select. Then the who is 5th one? 1 interim. That 1 interim, if M4 is selected, I2 cannot. So in this list, you cannot include I2. Okay. For example, if M1 is not there, which means M4, M5. If I select these 4 managers, here M1 is selected, here M1 is not selected. 2 possibilities. Okay, M3. In this case also, if M4 is selected, I2 cannot. In this case also, I2 cannot be in the interns list. So the answer for this question is I2. The interim I2 cannot. The interim I2 cannot. Good quality question. Now, the similar conditions and similar conditions, right? Similar conditions. And the question is, if M1 and M2 are selected and I2 is not selected, then which of the given options should represent the following team for the training? if M1 and M2 are selected, first option, if we see the first option, M1 and M2 are selected and I2 not selected, then which of the following should represent this is not, I2 not selected, he is given I2, that is not the team, that is not the possible team, M1, M2, M4, I2, I3, this is the team he is given. According to his statement, if M1, M2 are selected, I2 is not selected, that is the team, but he selected I2, this is not the possible team. Second team that is for, he is given M1, M2, M5, I1, I4, this is the team he has been given, should be possible, right? We'll see. M1, M2 selected, if M1 is selected, M3 should not, so in this M3 is not there. If M4 is selected, I2 should not, I2 is not there, right? This is the possibility. Let us check the option C, M1, M2, M4, M3, I3. Okay, if M1 is selected, M3 should not select, but he is selected M3, this is not the good correct team. Option D, M1, M2, I4, I2, I5. Is clear, there is no interim name I5. This is also not possible team. So the answer for this question is the possible team is option B. Superb question. Next, the similar data. Which of the given options is not a possible combination of the groups that can be sent for trying? Not possible, we have to. First option, M1, M2, M4. The team should consist of at least three managers, at least one term, if M is similar, right? So not possible, M1, M2, M4, I1, I3. Yeah, this is possible team. Yeah, next option is M1, M2, M5, I2, I3. This is also possible, all conditions are satisfied. Option C, M1, M2, M3, I2, I3. I think this is M1, M2, M3, I2, I3. I written option D, right? Straight away we can see, if M1 is selected, M3 should not, that is, just to look at glance we can. So this is not the possible combination. Option D is the answer, not possible combination. So similar, same data, if M2, M3, I2 form the three members of the team are M2, M3, I2, okay. Then who can be the other two members? What are the two members? Further, the first option is I1, I3. Is it possible? No, because we need at least three managers. If this is only two managers, one manager must be there. One manager must be there, because already two managers are there and we need minimum of three managers. So both interim should not. Next, M4, I3. I think this is possible group. M4, I3. If M4 is selected, then I2 should not be selected. If we select M4, here I2 should not. But I2 already is selected, M4 should not be in the team. So this is not. I2 is already there, so M4 should not. Option C, M5, I1. Is there any? If M1 is selected, sorry, M3 should not be selected. Okay. Here M5. I1. Yeah, this is absolutely possible. Option D will check. M1, I3. M1, I3. So if M1 is selected, M3 should not. Already M3 selected, we should not select M3. This is out. So this is the answer. The remaining two persons are M5, I1. That's it. Which will use the team of M2, M3, I2, M5, I1. That is the possible team which will select, which will use, which will satisfy all the conditions, all the criteria. Next, Christie is facing south. So definitely north, south, east, west. Let us change the color. Christie is facing south. From here, she is facing south. She walks 20 yards to the left. Left is this one, 20 yards. And take the right turn. Okay, right turn and walks 10. Let us say this is a 10 right turn. Now from here, then she takes left turn and walks 30. This is the left turn 30. Now finally, Christie is here. End. Okay. This is the starting. This is the starting. In which direction is she now facing with respect to her starting? With respect to her starting, now she is in southeast. Southeast, yeah, this is. Now she is in southeast. This is southeast. So that's the end of my part 1 regarding Amazon 2001 reasoning ability questions and its solutions, right? So this video will definitely helpful for you for preparation purpose. What kind of topics that you need to prepare for the upcoming drives, that guide, this will act as a guide. This is the entire paper explanation. That is the reason why I straight away explain the questions with a little bit of introduction part also. For the complete video course, you can contact the number that was given. Thank you, one and all. That's it.